Did you get it?
Yeah, I did actually. So this one I think I understand completely. So we know that from the last discussion we had about how you would recover the joint, that what you're saying on the right of this equation, probibility y times the probability of x given y, means that the probability of y, the variable y, doesn't depend on anything. So between those two graphs, the one on the right is the one where you're saying that you don't need to know the value of any other variable in order to determine the probability of y.
Good.
So it has to be the one on the second one. And then just to make sure, if you look at the second product, the probability of x given y, or the second multiplicand, is it multiplicand?
Factor.
Here. Factor? Let's say factor. The second factor, this says that, well, you determine the probability of x given the value of y, and there is an arrow from y to x. So the second one is, in fact, correct.
Yeah, so this is actually one way you could just read this network, is to say, what is this node x with an arrow coming into it? That is the probability of x, but the things pointing into it are exactly what's being given, what it's being conditioned on. So right. That's exactly right, the second one.
Right, and so this makes sense to me. This is why when you look at a network, a Bayesian network, it's very hard not to think of them as dependencies. Even though they're not dependencies, they're conditional independencies.
Well, the arrows are a form of dependence, but it's not a causal dependence necessarily. It's just the way that the probabilities are being decomposed.
Mm.
And the last of these three equations is just Bayes' rule, this time written correctly, where the denominator has to be the probability of x. And we've gone over this a couple times. I don't need to describe it again. But what I would like to just bring to your attention is that these three together turn out to be kind of our, three musketeers in working out the probability of various kinds of events.
Excellent.